Hello, today I want to show you how to work with email signatures in Outlook. This can save you a lot of time when creating a new email or just replying or forwarding an email, and you want to type in your name, company name, phone number, fax number, slogan, whole bunch of information, or maybe you're just a little bit of a slow typer and you don't want to have to repeat typing in a bunch of information at the bottom of every email. Whatever the reason is, this is going to show you how to set up a signature, how to edit your signatures, how to set them up for automatic every time you create a new email or forwarding or replying to emails, and the difference between Outlook 2007 and 2003 as far as working with signatures. So this is Outlook 2007, and I'm gonna go through the setting up of a signature here, and I'll show you where the differences are with 2003. The first thing you need to do is, from the main screen in Outlook, you need to go to Tools and go down to Select Options. That opens up the Options window. And if we go down, actually, we want to go to the Mail Format tab. So there should be the same in the 2003 version so far. And under Signatures, we can click the Signatures button. And then that gives us an option to create a new signature or edit an existing one. And what we're going to do here is create a new one, because I have one here already, but we'll assume one doesn't exist, and we'll call it test signature and hit OK. So that's highlighted now because we just created it, and at the box below we can click in there and start putting in our signature. So whatever information that you want to have. You can see different people's signatures and how they do it, just to get some ideas for creativity. You can do all sorts of things here. You can change the font if you like, and the size, and make it italicized. Maybe the company is bold and a little bigger. So you can do all kinds of things like that, and that's just simple font changes that you would do in Word. So you can see all the other options are here. So it's if you know how to work with fonts and type already, it's the same difference here. Now we've already created a signature, so before we hit OK, we need to see if we want this to come up automatically every time we create an email, and or every time we reply to an email or forward an email. In Outlook 2007, those options are in the same screen. We can choose our default signature for our emails. New messages, it wanted to use the one that I already had there, so I'll say test signature. And for replies and forwards would be the same thing. You could say none if you don't want any signature to appear by default. We can do that for new messages as well. So maybe you don't want it to show every single time. Maybe you have multiple signatures and you want to choose which one you want to send for that particular message. So you can have it set to none for more control. Now, in Outlook 2003, these options are not in this screen. We would have to hit OK first. So we're back at the options menu, but down where it says signatures, you'd have the signatures button, but you would also have those other options that we just saw that have the menus to choose for what signature, if any, do you want for new messages and replies and forwards. So exact same looking boxes with the same wording and so on, pretty much exactly, but it's located in this screen rather than where we edit the actual signature. That's the one difference for Outlook 2003. Now that this is set up, We can hit OK. We'll go to create a new email. And look at that. It's got our new signature automatically coming up. Now, if it's set to none, or you don't want that signature and you want a different one, you can go to Insert, Signature, and then choose the name of the signature. If you only have one signature, it'll only show one. We have two here, so now it shows this other signature now. One other difference now with Outlook 2007 and 2003 is here. When you have a signature already there in Outlook 2007, it will automatically overwrite that signature with the other one. So if you have one there and you go to Insert Signature and choose another signature, it will overwrite the one that was there with the one you just chose. In Outlook 2003, if you have a signature already there and you go to insert a second signature, it will not overwrite that signature. Instead, it will append that signature to the bottom of the one that's already there. So that's one other difference to keep in mind between Outlook 2003 and Outlook 2007. Also, in Outlook 2003, if you go to Insert Signature, it's not going to have a signature option there. It's going to be auto text, and it can be a bit more complicating to work with for the signatures. So if we get out of here and go back to our main screen again, you want to go to the Tools menu, back down to Options again, under the Mail Format, and at the top somewhere here, again, it's going to be different than mine. Here it's showing for the format for outgoing mail and how to compose messages. In Outlook 2003, it'll look a little different than my screen, but you'll have the options with two check marks similar to these that will say use Outlook or use Word as your default mail editor. And you would want to uncheck that option. Now, having it on can allow you to do some other fancy stuff in your email, but for the most part, if it's for business use, you're not going to care about that anyway. You want to have things work as smooth as possible. And experiment with this. It doesn't hurt to try it out, and if you don't like it, you can always put it back. But try it out, see what it does for you. If you're using Outlook 2003, uncheck the option here in the options window under the Mail Format tab at the very top here. Uncheck the box that says use Microsoft Word as your default mail editor, and then go down to the bottom and hit OK. So then when you go to create a new email and you go to Insert Signature, you will see the options in under Insert, you will see the option for signature, and under that you will see your actual signatures to choose from. So then when you click on whichever one that happens to be, it will show that signature. And that's it for setting up, editing, and using signatures for Outlook 2007. And hopefully you understand the difference between the 2003. Please post your comments, give me some feedback, let me know what else we can do for you here. Love to put up some more videos that are useful for you. Thank you very much, and bye for now.